On August 12th through the 14th, 2011, Rainbow Productions brought us the 24th annual Long Beach Jazz Festival. This three-day event promised to leave us sitting on the edge of our seats, and after 24 years of doing so, once again, they didn't disappoint. The seaside setting was breathtaking, right off the water in the beautiful Lagoon Park, located in Long Beach, California. The all-star lineup included some of the best from the contemporary jazz era to the classic R&B. Day one brought us Brian Colbertson and his Full Throttle Band, the sweet horns of Najee, the sexy sounds of Howard Hewett. For most of us, that would be an amazing show all by itself. But no, add in Alex Bugnon on the keyboard, Bill Withers' daughter, Kori Withers, and you've got something nothing short of amazing, giving us the feel that the theme of the show, which is jazz the way you like it, was about to kick into full effect. Day two, titled Daylight to Starlight, brought us old school to new school, smooth jazz to funky. To pull it off, the skills of the next great drummer were called in to start things off, followed by Everette Harp on the sax, Amel, Larrieux on the keyboard, the always amazing Michael Franks. A smooth mix of jazz and sexy vocals were performed by Kenny Lattimore and Kim Waters. They delivered a performance that was amazing. And the Whispers closed the show. Fans bopped their heads and tapped their feet as they sang along the songs that they've known and loved for years. By day three, those who were lucky enough to have tickets for all 3 days were beaming with anticipation. They just knew the day was going to bring something special, and they were not disappointed. The smell of barbecue was in the air, and fans were relaxed and mellow on the lawns, seaside by the bay. The day started with jazz from the Jazz Search winners, a trio of kids from Hamilton High School in Los Angeles that have been playing together for the past 2 years. Of course, you would have never guessed it to hear them play. They rocked the stage like veterans. Jackiem Joyner entertained us all with the sweet sounds of his saxophone, and Al Williams Jazz Society featuring Andrea Palm brought their unique brand of jazz to the stage. There was a touching tribute to Gil Scott Heron performed by Karen A. Clark. Kim hit the stage, and there was only one word to describe it: amazing. Right when you thought your senses couldn't take it anymore, master performer Charlie Wilson hit the stage to close out the show. The crowd was on their feet, their hands and their voices were in the air. All in all, the weekend was simply awesome. Next year marks the 25th anniversary of the Long Beach Jazz Festival. All I want to know is, where does the line form? Because I want to get in it now.